Over the last few videos, we've been talking about first-order differential equations, but we haven't really had any techniques to solve them. We've been looking at approximation techniques like slope fields and Euler's method and that kind of stuff. Well, we're finally ready, excuse me, finally ready to look at our first technique that will actually solve a differential equation and not give us an approximation to a solution. So as long as your first order, as long as your differential equation is first order, you can use this technique called separation of variables. That's what we're going to take a look at in this video. So first of all, what is separable mean? Well, a first order differential equation is called separable if you can write it like this. Normally, you remember how you can isolate the dy dx on the left-hand side, and then you just kind of just without a care in the world, throw everybody else on the right-hand side, and it becomes a function muddled with x's and y's. We don't really care what they are or where we put them, or we just toss everything in a big basket on the right-hand side, and becomes a function of x and y. That's not necessarily separable. Let me show you what separable is. You do get terms that have x and y on the right-hand side, but they have to be placed in a very specific fashion. It has to be able to be written as a function of x, we'll call it p of x, times a function of y, we'll call it q of y. The letters p and q are not important. You could have called them f and g or what have you, but the important thing is this: is you can write the right-hand side as a function of x times a function of y and separate those two into a product. Not a sum, but into a product. And if you can, then we would call this guy separable, and we have a way of actually solving it. All right, so here's the idea. Here's the idea behind separation of variables. If you have dy dx equals a function of x times a function of y, then what you're able to do is sort these guys on either side of the equal sign. We can separate the x's to be on one side and the y's to be on the other. Specifically, you could write it like this. You could take the p of x and divide it. I'm sorry, let's leave the p of x there. Let's divide the q of y to get it over here with the dy. So you have 1 over q of y dy. So you only have y's on the left. And let's take that dx and let's multiply him to the right to be over here with the p of x. And so, as the name suggests, these variables have been separated. You have y's on this side, and you have x's on this side. And that's what we're after. All right, now, what do we do at this point? Well, you can see this is kind of primed and ready to do some integration. All right, so what we do next is, since you only have y's on the left, let's integrate this expression with respect to y, and let's integrate this expression with respect to x. And what happens when you do that is the differentials are removed, and you don't have a derivative anymore. You just have one expression equal to another one. And this will wind up being your solution to the differential equation. So we're using integration to get rid of the derivative here. Now, this is only possible, this only works when the first order differential equation is separable like this. If you can't write it like this, then you're not going to be able to separate the variables and you're not going to be able to integrate. So let me show you how this works with a short example. This is a very easy example just to get our feet wet. We'll do some more difficult examples in the later videos. But let's say dy dx equals 2x times y. This is obviously separable because I wrote it that way. It's 2x times y. It's a function of x times a function of y. And so let's separate these variables. I'll move the dx to the right, and we'll have 2x dx. And I'll move the y, I'll divide it to the left, and we'll have 1 over y dy. Okay, so I've separated the variables. Let me integrate these both now. The left side would become natural log of the absolute value of y. That's a good old-fashioned calc 1 integral. Equals, and the integral of 2x would be x squared plus c. solve for the y if that's possible. It's not always possible, but if we can, let's solve for the y. In this case, we can. Y, by raising both sides, e to the left-hand side and e to the right-hand side to get rid of the logarithm, we would get e to the x squared times e to the c, but I'll just write a generic constant out front here. So my point is not so much to technically work through an example, but just to illustrate the process of separation of variables. So this guy would be the solution to this differential equation. You can check it, take his derivative, and see if that winds up being 2x times the original, and I bet it does. What I want to leave you with in this video is just a short quiz. Now, we're not going to work these out in this video, but I want you to jot these down, and then we'll actually work them out in the next video here. But this, I'm giving you a sneak peek. This is what's going to be covered in the next video. So my question is, are these three separable? Is there some algebra you can do to write these guys once you solve for dy dx as a function of x times a function of y? And it's not quite as easy as it sounds. Some of these are a little tricky, so take it slow, do it carefully, and I'll give you the answers in the next video.